Cocoibius. So, as opposed or in contrast to last week's primer review that was a bit of a disappointment, here is a primer that I've really been enjoying. So this is the Hourglass Mineral Veil Primer. This is just a little sample size, but the full 1 ounce retails for $60 at Sephora. It looks like they have a couple different options on this website. So we've got like a 2 ounce jumbo one and then a 0.33 ounce, probably like a little travel size one. So we've got some options on what to get. This one is a little sample that I've been trying out. As you can see, I've put a serious dent into it. Well, serious for how much makeup I have and how many different things I can alternate every given day. So I have been really, really enjoying this. From what I've seen, I think the full size comes with a pump. This one has a little bit of a random applicator. It's just like a weird little spatula thing that the bestie would probably enjoy poking people with. If you've watched my vlog, my Vegas vlog, you know what I'm talking about. I'll link it down below anyways. But yeah, I've been wearing this guy and generally really, really enjoying it. I think it was my friend Noelle, who has an awesome Instagram that I will link down below. Hi, if you're watching. She was saying that she's also been trying this one out recently, really enjoying it. She likes the way that it gives an airbrush finish to the face, but not necessarily the way it covers pores, and I could not agree more. That's exactly what it does. It's what I have on today. Bring you in closer. So yeah, as you can hopefully tell, it's just, it gives a really soft finish to the face. I don't know if the artificial lights are gonna help you be able to see. Like, I can still tell that I have my larger pores. My pores have been very large recently, I don't know why. But I can still tell that they're there, but it's almost like they're just softened. It doesn't fill in my pores like some of my pore minimizing primers do, but it gives it enough of a soft finish that, unless I'm me with like my mirror right up close to my face, I can't see them, and so, you know what I mean. I really, really do love just the finish that it gives. I do still tend to concentrate it in these areas, sort of like my T-zone and then the inner part of my cheeks and a little bit on my chin. I don't put it all the way everywhere. I just don't feel like I need that much primer everywhere, but I do love the soft finish that it gives to the face. So yeah, I'm gonna insert a little demo of me.
What I do tend to do, which is probably not the most hygienic thing, is I just take the spatula straight and I like product on the spatula straight onto my face. My face will have been just washed when I'm putting on my makeup, but still, I like the fact that the full size comes with a pump.
It is white in the tube, but once it gets on the face, it has almost like a purplish sheen to it, which is interesting. It mixes really quickly, it absorbs really quickly into the face. That's something that I will say, it absorbs really quickly. It's really light and almost is like a very lightweight like face cream. Like a lot of my other primers, because they're pore minimizing, tend to be thicker. This one is really nice and cream-like almost on the face. It has the same kind of consistency as my Smashbox Blemish Control Primer, but that one I still find to be a little tacky, whereas this one I feel really just absorbed right into the face. And so it makes it really easy to put on the face. Does it have a smell? It has a little bit of a chemical-y, no, sorry. It has a very clean smell to it, which is really nice. It does dissipate pretty quickly, but when you're initially applying it, it's nice that there's that cleanliness to it. It makes you feel like, I don't know, somehow it's good for your skin. It does have a bit of an SPF to it. So it's got SPF 15 to it, which is nice. It adds a little bit of SPF to your face. I tend to like some slightly more SPF to my face, so I will put on a separate SPF, but if it's a day that's not too sunny or you like lower SPFs, this guy is good. It'll give you your SPF all in one. One shade, but it comes in a couple different sizes, like I said. Sephora, Hourglass.com, all those kind of good places you can try it out. Definitely an A+ in my books, and I think I will repurchase the full size once I finish this guy, just because I like what it does and it's not like any of my other primers. That's it. I think that's all I want to tell you guys. Let us know if you've tried it out and your thoughts on it. Any of your favorite primers that you've either rediscovered or have been tried and true for a long time, let us know down in that comment section. I think that's it for me today. I'm going to do 3 points of positivity and I will be done for the day. So my first point of positivity has definitely been you guys and all the love and support you've been extending me. I really, really appreciate it. It could not have come at a better time during this transition, and I just really don't say it enough. I could say it all day long and I wouldn't say it enough. Thank you guys so much for your unending love and support, and for making me feel understood. I think that's one of the most important things in life, is to find people that understand you and make you feel accepted exactly the way you are. You guys have done nothing if not that. So thank you genuinely from the bottom of my heart.
My second point of positivity is finally catching up on YouTube videos. I've been so behind. My like watch list has been growing. And I finally have steady internet connection and I can, you know, find bits and pockets of time to watch. And so it's been really lovely to feel like I'm coming home and watching everyone and catching up on videos. So that has definitely been amazing. And then my third point of positivity is nothing makes me feel like my old tried and true self other than stalking cosmetic company websites. So there's some new collections launching, obviously, for the holidays. Release dates are a little bit different here in the UK than they were back home. So I've been trying to figure out dates and stalking like a mad woman and feeling more like myself as a result. So that's definitely the third thing that's making me smile today. As always, let me know what's been bringing you guys joy in these past days. I want to send you guys tons of happiness. Huge, huge hugs. And as always, I really, really want to thank you and remind you that life is just too short to wear boring lipstick. Bye, guys.